Are you a soldier main? Are your gunboats nailed to your feet? Do you swear by the escape plan? Are you sick and tired of carrying your team in pubs while getting doned mid-rocket jump by a bot? If you answered yes to these questions, then this is the guide for you. Alright, so before I can actually start the guide, I need to go over some common misconceptions that new players have about playing the class. The reason I have to go over these misconceptions is because if you start forming bad habits early, they're going to affect you and your team negatively in the long run. The first and most common misconception is that it is always your job to kill the other team's medic. It is only your job to kill the other team's medic during stalemates. More on this later in the video. You have to remember to value your life when playing sixes. You are 16% of your team. If you are dead all the time, your flank will be left wide open. As a soldier, you are well equipped to hold down choke points with your splash rockets. Outside of teamfights, it is not just a good idea to hold down the flank as roamer. It is your main job. The big takeaway from this misconception is to value your life. Okay, so with all that out of the way, you should know that it is sometimes your job to sacrifice your life to go for the other team's medic. It really just depends on the situation, and I'll talk about this more later. Moving on to the second misconception that a lot of new players have. Since you are the roamer, you are a lone wolf. Make no mistake, this isn't Call of Duty, it's Team Fortress 2. If you want to win, you need to work together with your team to avoid fights where you have the disadvantage and take fights where you have the advantage. The most obvious way to do this is avoid any fights unless you have the number advantage. Never take fair fights, even if you think you have better aim. You always want the fight to be stacked in your favor. You win more that way. This seems really obvious that you should do this, but so many MGE lords get into the habit of fighting 1v1s, and it usually comes back to bite them. And just to clarify, there are more ways that you can have an advantage other than numbers. More on this later. Each round starts with your team spawning in randomized locations in the spawn room. Your medic, if they know what they're doing, should be trying to immediately start healing your Demoman. You and your scout should immediately crouch to make it easier for your medic to heal your Demoman. While this is happening, your team's pocket soldier will begin his rollout. It is very important that you don't take any damage before your medic is able to buff you. You need to maintain your crit heals, which if you don't know what that is, I'll link a video in the description explaining crit heals in depth. You can find rollouts on YouTube for any map at rollout.tf. In this video, I'll be going over Sunshine's rollout. Let's take a look at this concept in slow motion. Here you see myself and my two scouts crouching so the medic can reach the Demoman. At the same time, our medic is buffing our Demoman not once but twice to 260 HP. Also notice how the pocket soldier began his rollout as soon as he could. Now the medic is beaming his scouts so he can get scout speed to get to mid faster. Finally, the medic will arrow the pocket soldier and choke, and then ideally give him as much of a crit heal as possible. I will link a guide in the description that explains this process more in depth. Okay, so now I'm going to show you what it looks like from the roamer point of view. Normally you would have a full 300 buff, but I just recorded this rollout on a private server since I don't actually have any footage of me doing the rollout. Usually on Sunshine Mid, I like to shoot a couple of rockets towards the choke to try to damage the other team's scouts. I'll go over what to do once you get to the mid later on in this video. For now, I'll just show you the default rollouts for the rest of Sunshine. The next topic I'm going to cover is midfights. Before I start talking about midfights, I just want to point out that the background footage is just going to be a whole bunch of frags. Recording and then editing enough footage to go over what I'm going to talk about would be kind of a nightmare and take forever, so I'm just not going to. I'll try my best to explain things without the help of a visual aid. But anyways, now that you know how to reach mid as fast and healthy as possible, let's talk about what you should actually do once you get there. So typically your team's main caller will call out what mid they want you to do before you even start rolling out, so keep this in mind before you begin talking about what you want to do with your team. Just a quick side tangent, as the roamer you should never be main calling. A flank main caller is not plausible and no high level teams do it for a reason. Alright, now that we've gotten all of the disclaimers out of the way, let's talk about the first and most simple midfight, the aggressive midfight. This type of midfight is most common on maps that have choke pointy mids like Metalworks or Gullywash. most teams do is they have both of their soldiers bomb forward and the rest of their team will walk forward as well and call focus fires. Really, the way that this works is that your team is able to shoot the same person and kill them really quickly, and then they rinse and repeat. Most teams don't know whether or not they should be looking at the soldiers or the players walking forward, and they aren't sure what to shoot, and then they end up just dying. So some important skills that your team needs to have to be successful in an aggressive midfight would be your soldiers having the ability to coordinate to bomb at the exact same time. So what my team would do is I would tell my pocket soldier that we should bomb at, say, 9:37 on the clock, and then our team will walk forward at that time, and our soldiers will both bomb. It is really important that somebody in your team is calling focus fires and that you are actually all shooting the same person, otherwise this mid will not be as successful as it could be. Like I said, coordination and deathmatch ability is the name of the game when it comes to aggressive mid fights. Your team needs to be able to secure kills before you start dying. If you can do this mid effectively, you can easily snowball a couple of kills and roll the other team to their last, winning the round. As far as ROAMER specific tips for the aggressive mid goes, I recommend that you try to land on high ground, that way it is more difficult for you to get focused down when you do end up landing near the enemy team. I would also avoid going for medics on the mid fights, since it is better to focus down classes that can deal more damage, and if you kill them quicker, your team will take less damage and be able to push their advantage more after you win the mid. In addition, a medic will not have Uber for the mid fight, and he can only heal a very small portion of what your team will be able to deal as damage, so it is not a priority pick on the mid fight unless you are starting to lose the mid. I typically would like to go for the Demoman, but a scout or a soldier pick is still much better than going for the medic right away. If you're able to kill all of the medic's teammates or most of them, it's really easy to chase them down after the mid's over. Okay, so moving on to another common mid, the rotate mid fight. You're most likely to see this mid fight on maps like Sunshine and Process. Some teams also play this way on Metalworks. The way you play this type of mid is that your team, usually your Demoman, picks a direction to go, either left or right. Then your whole team, and I mean your whole team, not just 4, not just 5, but all 6, go that direction. You don't want to split up from your team. If you go the opposite direction from your team, you risk the other team rotating into you, essentially taking a 1v6. Okay, so once you get to mid, you all want to go one direction and rotate around the point. You want to keep rotating as the mid continues and continue to call focus fires as you are rotating. Most teams will continue to rotate around the point until they have a player advantage or a significant damage lead. From there, you can either continue rotating until the other team leaves or transition into an aggressive mid. If you find yourself losing on the mid, you can do one of two things. Either try to rotate around to your choke point and try to escape, or full commit on the other team's med to try to get a med pick. If the other team is losing the mid, be ready for them to try to full commit on your medic. If they decide to leave through their choke point and you have 6 up and they are down players, you should have your flank scout cap and the rest of your players chase. If you were able to kill the other team's medic and keep yours alive, you should be able to push their last with full uber advantage. I suppose I should have mentioned this earlier, but if you were able to consistently win mids with 6 up, you'll be able to snowball last easily and win entire rounds off just your midfight and forward momentum. This is why midfights are so important in this game. As a roamer on rotate mids, it is your job to fight for high ground, and once you have it, deal damage to the other team so your scouts can clean up. You can also try bombing the other team on rotate mids, but you do need to be careful because if both scouts are with the other team's medic, you will most likely die very quickly. You can also try going for flanks on rotate mids. More about that later. Another common strategy on mids is to play passive. The point of this mid is to sit back and spam the other team, waiting for an opportunity to strike. My team likes to do this mid if we know the other team likes to play an aggressive mid. We wait for their soldiers to bomb so our scouts can focus them down so we can be up players for the rest of the mid. Once you hear that the other team is taking a lot of damage, or you get some frags, you can transition to an aggressive mid. The last common midfight tactic you will see often is a flank mid. This is where a player, usually a soldier, will get behind the enemy team. Then that player commits back to the fight while the rest of their team walks forward. You will see this most on Gully Wash, where soldiers like to roll out to the other team's dropdown, or Snake Water, where soldiers like to roll out into the other team's kitchen or catwalk. I also like rolling out to my team's cafe on Sunshine if I know the other team likes to rotate in that direction. This tactic can be effective if the other team isn't expecting it, but keep in mind you risk not only your team being forced to take a 5v6 fight, and also your flanker dying early on in the mid-fight. I wouldn't recommend flank mids to new teams since it is better to master more reliable ways of winning the mid-fight. I do recommend experimenting and finding what works best for your team. I think the most important thing that you can do is avoid being predictable. Don't do the same mid over and over, or the other team will begin to expect it and adapt. If your team is able to do multiple types of mid on each map, you will figure out what works best for you and what you still need to work on as a team. Even though midfights determine the pace of the game, they are not the only decider of what team wins the round. In a 6v6 environment, the game state can often be classified into one of three stages: advantage, disadvantage, and stalemate. An advantage is usually referred to as add, and disadvantage as disadd. Simply put, add or disadd situations are just an inequality of the two teams. These inequalities can include Uber, numbers, health, ammo, and team composition. Stalemate is just a situation where both teams are waiting for an advantage to push off of. If you remember earlier in the video when I talked about how you should never take a fight unless you have an advantage, this is what I was talking about. During stalemate, both teams know that if they push with no add, they will most likely lose that fight since the other team will be able to spam them out before they gain enough space to have a chance of winning that team fight. This video is already getting long, so I only cover the most important advantages to have: Uber, numbers, and health. The most obvious of the three to spot is numbers advantage. If you have more players alive, you should push. If you have less players, you should expect the other team to push. As a general rule of thumb for newer teams, you can push off of a numbers advantage if you are up two players or if the other team is missing their demo, since demo is the best at denying space. Moving on to Uber add. It is your medic's job to keep track of Uber add. There are plenty of guides for this on YouTube, so I won't go over how to do this. As a roamer, all you need to know for Uber is that you need to make sure that your team knows that the other medic died if you killed him or if you forced him. Alright, so here are the rules of thumbs when it comes to Uber add. If you have full Uber add, you should be trying to push. If you have full Uber disadd, you should be trying to keep your medic safe and try to kill force their medic unless you are holding last. If you're holding last with full Uber disadd, your scout should be off-classing on engineer, heavy, pyro, etc. to slow them down. Please note that Uber advantage and disadvantage is usually just referred to as add or disadd. You don't need to specify that you're talking about Uber. As your medic gets better at the format, he will be able to tell more often and more accurately whether or not your team is add, and will be calling that more and more frequently. The last type of advantage I want to talk about in this video is health. Let's say you know that both teams have 6 players up and full Uber, but you know that all of their players just took 100 damage. It makes sense for your team to push since you will probably win the fight, even though you don't have Uber or number advantage. Obviously, all these examples are very straightforward and it's difficult to tell these things in game, but these are just the general ideas, and like I said, this is a very nuanced topic, so I might make an entirely different video about just advantage and disadvantage. Okay, since we don't have much time, I want to move on to stalemates. I mentioned at the beginning of this video that it's not usually the roamer's job to feed for the medic. Except during stalemates. When both teams have even Uber, it is actually the roamer's job to sacrifice his life in order to try to make a play and gain some sort of advantage. So what exactly you want to do for a sac is highly dependent on the map and the situation, but here's a general kind of rule of thumb. So your bread and butter bombs for roamer sacs are going to be 2 rocket bombs where you jump off of the ground and then off of a wall, and then you airstrafe and try to not get airshot and hit by scouts while you try to either sink rockets onto the medic or land a direct hit and then a splash rocket to kill the medic or force him. Again, this is a complex subject, so it probably will be its own video. In the next episode, I will go more into depth about sacking as well as pushing with advantage. In the meantime, if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or swing by my Twitch stream.